everybody, how's it going? We have our friend Agent Maxine here.
Hi, how's it going? Hi, how you doing?
And right back there in the cowboy outfit, that's our friend Jimmy the Zombie Hens back there. There we go.
Oh, no.
We're going to have music and laughter and entertainment and a nice shave, I might add.
Fortunately, we fed the zombie, so he's not going to eat us, so don't worry.
This is good. I've already prepped my face with the Vanuole pre-shave oil right there.
Really?
Really.
Really? All right.
My razor is going to be the Super Max two-piece quick model right there.
Ah, Max, like Maxine.
Right. Super Maxine. And in there I have, on its first use, a generic double-edged blade right there.
Generic?
Yeah, you can get these. They're no name, see? You can get them at your supermarket, your drugstore. I think they're actually made by Dorco in Vietnam, but I'm the biggest Dorco there is, so... You shouldn't blame it on the Vietnamese, okay?
Yeah. Now, well, we could, but...
My brush is going to be this Yaqui 24mm synthetic... it's called the Sagrada Familia brush, and that means Holy Family, as in similar, I guess, to the Holy Family Basilica, which was designed by the architect Gaudi, still not finished, in Barcelona.
Yeah, that sounds a little gaudy.
Well, and let's give a shout out and some prayers to our friends whose, well, the cathedral, the Notre Dame, has been burning over there in
so
Paris.
Sad. Because the cathedral's so pretty,
yeah,
and it got all burned up.
Well, it didn't all get burned up, and yeah, let's show a little respect here. Using, using the Timeless Razor shaving bowl here, and in there I have some of this. It is the Gillette Lime Cream, which I come to find out comes in an itty bitty tube. It's about your size right there. Yeah, but. Itty-bitty tube of Gillette there, and...
Too bad you don't have a coconut to take and mix it up in. Lime in a coconut.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna lather up here. I hope I didn't over wet this, but...
We need now? We need some music.
Some lathering music. Go ahead, zombie, yeah.
Oh, hey.
I'm getting this all over, but that's okay. I was so excited about the zombie and the puppet and everything that, the shaving only seems incidental right now. All right. Watch Don fling leather all over the place. Okay, that's good. That's good for now, zombie. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, zombie.
Yeah, all right. We're moving right along here. I'm going to commence with pass number one, with the grain. I'm going to wet
with the grain.
And, zombie, while I'm shaving this first pass, could I get you to do some Jim Reeves for our friend, the great one, whose name we are not worthy
to mention?
Worthy
to mention, yes, because we're not worthy. We're not worthy. We're not worthy.
Yes, darling, you're now free to go. You're saying you're sorry you hurt me. But you've hurt me much more than you know. And you're asking from where this call comes from. Well, I hope that you don't end up here. 'Cause if your new love should turn out a failure, here's where you'll find me, my dear. I'm just on the blue side of lonesome, right next to that Heartbreak Hotel. in a tavern that's known as Three Teardrops. On a bar stool, not doing so well.
Isn't that pretty, Agent Max?
Yeah, very pretty, pretty, pretty.
The carpet is withered in sorrow. Though no one can weep in the aisle. And they say someone broke the bar mirror.
With only a ghost of a smile. Got a weeper.
Hands on the clock never alter. Poor things never change in this place.
You're telling me, huh?
There's no present, no past, or no future. We're the ones who got lost in love's race. I'm just on the blue side of lonesome. Right next to the Heartbreak Hotel. In a tavern that's known as Three Teardrops.
On a bar stool, not doing so well.
On a bar stool, not doing so well.
Because I got a weeper in my
mouth.
I'm gonna owe the zombie big time, you know. Like,
yeah, so.
Like my firstborn and.
Well, you know, it cost an arm and a leg. But fortunately, it doesn't matter whose arm or leg.
Hey, you want to growl for us and give us some of that cattle call? We like. Yeah. All right.
Thank you, Jerry.
You're welcome.
Well, Jimmy, you want to tell
everybody ought to have
one. Want to tell the fine folks what you did earlier tonight? You and your band there.
Oh yeah, I was with the Homestead Harmonizers. We had a practice here.
Oh okay. Where do you go for your practice?
Presbyterian Church.
Oh okay. Cool, cool. And then you play gigs all over the area, don't you? So if anybody needs Jimmy for a gig, it'll cost some money, and you'll have to provide transportation. That is, if you're way out on one of the coasts. But yeah, let me know. Get a hold of me.
Better yet, if you want the whole band, I can give you the number to call.
Oh, well, go ahead. There's
It would be the 520-2038. Of course, not some Lincoln. So
oh, so that would be
402-520-2038.
Okay, and I'll put that up on the screen. Let's say that one more time for the fine folks. Area code 402.
1402. Got to have a one because you're long distance.
Okay.
And then 402-520-2038.
Okay.
Dave Krupicka.
Oh, okay. Dave Krupicka.
K-R-U-P-I-C-K-A.
Okay.
Yeah.
Easy right. For you to spell.
Yeah.
It's a good old Bohemian name, that's why.
Well, I'm doing my third pass against the grain here. I did, I got so excited I gave myself a weeper on my nose, but that's okay.
Well,
it doesn't hurt.
Let me have a little say here. We would like to thank Don, Conversational Shaving, for helping us out when Dave was really studying really, really hard. And he did the AZMAX-T report, believe it or not.
And Dave is now a what?
A CNA, a certified nurse's aide.
And we
knew. Passed his test because I cracked a whip on him. Yeah, I did.
And we knew he was certifiable, right?
Right.
Okay.
Now now the state of Nebraska certified him.
So.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm getting a little off camera here.
Yeah,
the shaving is just kind of incidental. This is just a very a very special event for us here tonight. Because Dave studied.
And not every day that Dave becomes a nurse's aide and you get a zombie to play the piano for you while you're shaving. And a puppet in the bathroom. Now,
how's
that
coffee?
Just not an everyday thing.
Oh, try my coffee and see if
you.
Zombie's going to try the coffee back there.
Coffee here a little bit.
Okay. I hope it's strong enough.
Very good.
Oh, good.
All right. You're
going to make extra special. Extra special for the zombie there. And we're not calling him zombie to make fun of him. He likes zombie
movies.
Right,
he actually likes zombies.
Yeah, so we're not just being cruel or whatever.
No,
this guy really likes zombie movies.
Yes, he does. He likes something that walks and isn't alive.
Well, he came
we
to the
can't
right
say
place.
The word, can't say what it is, but it's something that walks and is not alive.
What are you getting at, Maxine? I don't get it.
Like a Walking Dead.
You're not supposed to say that. That's a copyrighted name.
Oh,
copyrighted
okay.
Name.
Right. All right, whatever. Well, anyway,
you get in trouble.
Maxine, you know what time it is?
It's 3, 2, 1. Pick up time, baby.
Yay!
Yay!
All right. So I'll just rinse the razor here, and since we're doing this without cuts, some cuts, just on my nose, though. I'll go ahead and lather up just under my chin on my neck for pickups, and we'll get done here pretty soon. That way we can put the zombie to bed, because he's staying up.
Yeah, because zombies need their sleep.
Yeah, he's staying up late for
and
us.
So does Amanda Maxine.
Oh, all right.
David got up really, really early today, and he's like, really beat.
Yeah. So you really, you helped him study, right, Maxine?
Oh, yeah, I had to crack the whip.
Now, tell the good folks the part that I helped him study that I got, I ran the category.
Well,
you can say it. Mental health.
Mental health.
Because, you know, me and mental health are good old friends, right?
Yeah, well.
Hang your head.
Maybe the lack thereof.
Mental health will drive you mad.
Keep it up, yeah.
Mental health will drive you mad.
All right. I was not expecting that one. Right. Yeah.
You like my new dress? Pam gave it to me.
Oh, Pam, yeah.
Yeah, this is my new dress.
Agent Maxine has a new dress.
Yeah, and I have a new dress for...
I've got weepers and bleeders.
Easter tomorrow, too. Easter Sunday, too.
Well, that's this coming Sunday, right?
And we have another video coming up this week where we're going to do a video about the public library.
Excuse me, I gotta reach over here. Sorry, everybody.
Uh-oh, it's an earthquake.
It's an earthquake.
You won't do your daddy's will. So, Lucille, you won't do your daddy's will. Well, there ain't nothing to you, but I love you still.
All right.
Lucille.
Smell pretty, pretty.
Come back where you belong.
It's just witch hazel, unscented witch hazel.
Oh, Lucille, please come back where you belong.
Figaro from Budapest, Hungary.
Wonder how hungry the Ray is.
That's the zombie.
Hey, zombie, how hungry is the Ray?
Baby, please don't do me wrong. Well, I woke up this morning, Lucille was not inside. I asked my friends about her, but all their lips were tight. Lucille, please come back where you belong.
I'm gonna try to have a little styptic pencil.
I really love you, baby. Please don't do me wrong.
Almost down.
Well, I woke up this morning, Lucille was not in sight. I asked my friends about her, but all their lips were tied. Lucille, please come back where you belong. Well, I really love you, baby. Please don't do your daddy wrong. Lucille, baby, satisfy my heart. Lucille, baby, satisfy my heart. I can't come around you, baby, but you gave me such a formidable scar. Lucille.
We're about done here. I'll do quick recaps while the zombie takes us out. I mean, I hope he doesn't literally take us out, because zombies get hungry, you know.
Yes, they do.
But, okay, I began beforehand. I prepped my face with Vanuole pre-shave oil.
Oh, yeah.
And my razor's been this two-piece...
Yeah, you really do smell pretty, pretty.
Thank you. The razor's been this two-piece plastic Super Max Quick Razor, K-W-I-K. Mm-hmm. In there, on its first use, a generic double-edged blade available at supermarkets, drugstores, any place that sells their own brand of generic blades. Mm-hmm. Maybe that's why I cut my nose. I don't know. I was just so excited about zombies and puppets, you know. Oh, let's see.
It can affect a person.
Yes. What did I do with... What did I do with my shaving cream? There it is. The Gillette Lime shaving cream, the itty-bitty tube there.
No coconut necessary.
No coconuts necessary. Lathered in the Timeless Razor shaving bowl with this Yaqui 24mm Sagrada Familia brush.
Sagrada Familia.
Right. Well, and used Humphrey's Unscented Witch Hazel. I got to get some.
I know a guy named Humphrey's.
Well, don't mention him or we'll have to bow and grovel. the great one, you know. Used Figaro aftershave from
Figaro
in the clear plastic bottle. And finally, excuse me, I finished up with the ProRazzo sensitive post shave.
ProRazzo.
And I may still be bleeding here, but I don't care because this has been so much fun. The shaving's only been incidental to this. Thanks once again to Jimmy the Hens, or Jimmy the Zombie Hens, your musical accompaniment, and to Agent Maxine from Fun with Agent Maxine. That's all, folks. I'm going to shut her down and thank you all. Peace.
Bye-bye.